guys, in today's video, it's a beautiful buttercream texturized cake. I'm going to show you how to use a palette knife and how to create little petals and flowers, and also how to do a stucco effect. So if you guys want to see how I made this, well, keep on watching.
I first did my crumb coat, pop it in the freezer for about 5 to 10 minutes, and this is my second coat of buttercream. I'm applying more buttercream at the top, and the reason why is because I want an uneven look at the top. Remove the excess of buttercream using your metal scraper. There's numerous ways of creating the stucco effect, but what I'm doing right now is simply dipping my plastic wrap into buttercream and simply tapping it onto my cake. The best way to create this technique is to make sure that your cake is chill. You can create the same technique using also paper towel or even like a palette knife. So I started with my base color, which as you can see is a white buttercream. And then what I'm going to do is go over that color with another color, and I chose to go with green. The fact that you're adding a second color, it gives it like a three dimension to the look. It's really, really pretty. And you can also add like a third color if you'd like. And now to make the petals, what I'm doing is basically using palette knives, as you can see, but I'm also mixing two of my colors that I use for the stucco effect, so the white and the green. And I really like this technique because it gives it like a marble effect. I like to create my colors and just place it on a silicone mat, and like that it's easier for me to just pick up the colors that I want. So I'm going to pick up the white and the green, and I'm going to place it onto the side of my palette knife, as you saw. And then I'm just going to press it onto my cake and then just release the palette knife, and this will create like a little crease, which will be obviously your petal. There's different palette knives that you can use that have different shapes, so it's really up to you to decide what kind of look that you want to go for. There's some smaller ones, there's some larger ones, so it's really endless of what you can do with these amazing tools. So for this particular cake, I went with 2 and 3 petals for the cake, and you're going to do like one petal first, and then you're going to simply place a second petal right next to the first one that you did, and then the third one right next to the second one. And basically what this is going to do is just going to squeeze the first petal, or the petal next to it, if that makes sense, and it's just going to create some dimensions. Using a clean small brush, I'm going to paint at the bottom of the petals using edible metallic paint by Rainbow Dust. Make sure that when you do this technique that your cake is completely chill, or else it's just going to smudge the buttercream. Make sure that whatever product that you're using, it does have the label that it says edible. I'm using some pearls by Sweet Apolita. If you guys are interested, I have a promo code. It's in my description box of this video, and it's Liliana Springs for 15% off. I'll also be adding some white pearls by Sweet Apolita also, just to give it another dimension to the cake. By the way, all the products that I'm using in the video will be linked in my Amazon store. And I finished off the cake with a beautiful cake topper from my Etsy shop. Here's a sneak peek of my shop if ever you guys need some cake toppers or cupcake toppers, and the link will be in my description box of this video. I also sell custom cake toppers just like this one. If that's the case, just send me a message and we'll figure it out together and finish the look with a cute dove. This is the final look, a very beautiful, elegant cake. Let me know if you liked it in the comments. Please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to click the notification bell button so you get notified of all the videos that I put up. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Mwah!